What's up, guys? Good morning. Another amazing day. It's Monday. Grateful to be here. Hopefully you had a great weekend. It's about 4 a.m. I'm up early, like every morning. So let's get right into it. Before I get started, don't forget to drop a like. Think about subscribing if you're not subscribed yet. I make Mullen content every single day. And of course, don't forget to grab your coffee. Here's mine. So today I'm going to be talking about the 8K. I'm going to show you exactly what I'm looking at. And a lot of people have been talking about it, and there's a lot of confusion out there. What I tell you, with my opinion, might be incorrect, but this is how I'm viewing it, and this is what I think is the answer to the 8K situation. Of course, nothing I say is financial advice. I'm not a financial advisor. This is really for entertainment purposes only and giving you my honest opinion about Mullen Company. And I do believe RRDS is going to be absolutely huge for Mullen Company, and I'm gonna break that down for you. So this is the most important part of the 8K. So let's break this down line for line so that we're very clear on what they are telling us here. On May 3rd, 2023, Mullen Automotive filed a certificate of amendment to its second amended and restated certificate of incorporation with the Secretary of State of the state of Delaware to effect a 1-for-25 reverse stock split, okay? So basically, they're taking the 25 shares, they're turning it into one, right? Of its common stock, the reverse stock split was effective on May 4th, 2023 at 12:01 a.m. Eastern time. Okay, so that paragraph is very simple. If you had 10,000 shares of Mullen, when the reverse stock split happened, you should now have 400 shares. 10,000 divided by 25 equals 400, okay? So you're taking the 25 shares and you're turning it into one. So we have less shares now, but your portfolio value doesn't change unless the stock price moves up or down. At the company's reconvened special meeting of stockholders held on January 19, 2023, the stockholders approved a proposal to authorize a reverse stock split of the company's common stock at a ratio within the range of 1-for-2 to 1-for-25. I believe most people believed that if a reverse stock split did happen, it would definitely be 1-for-25 so that we could get over that dollar threshold so that we are NASDAQ compliant, which we are, right? We have 8 more trading days to stay above a dollar. I do personally believe that we'll stay above a dollar. What do you think though? Do you think we'll actually go below a dollar and then not be NASDAQ compliant again? And then more issues, you know, another meeting would have to happen possibly. Another reverse stock split would have to happen. This would be very, very bad. Worst case scenario, which I don't even think is going to happen whatsoever. I think now that we're NASDAQ compliant, we're good to go. This is the last piece of the puzzle. Now it's time to really dominate with Mullen Company. All right, last paragraph. As a result of the reverse stock split, at the effective time, every 25 shares of the company's pre-reverse stock split common stock was combined and automatically became one share of common stock. I just explained that to you all. The company's post-reverse stock split common stock began trading on May 4th, 2023 with a new CUSIP number of, and you can see it right there. This is the important line. The reverse stock split did not change the authorized number of shares or the par value of the common stock, nor modify any voting rights of the common stock. The reverse stock split did not change the authorized number of shares. Okay, the authorized number of shares was 5 billion, correct? Correct me if I'm wrong. So with them putting this line in, my honest belief would be that the 5 billion is still the number, okay? But what could happen is 5 billion could still be the number, but the other side of me thinks, okay, if they've already issued 3.8 billion shares, give or take, there's about 1.2 billion shares left, right, of the 5 billion. So if they just wanted the 1.2 left, if you divide that by 25, that's about 48 million shares left to issue. So 48 million shares left to issue, not a big deal compared to closer to 1.2 billion shares available to issue, but that wouldn't really make sense. So this line is very confusing, okay? The question is, are they still able to issue 5 billion shares after the reverse stock split happened, or is it 48 million left? So it's a very confusing sentence. A lot of people are saying that no, it's 5 billion is available still, and they're and then they're subtracting it from the reverse stock split number after the split happened. So it's very confusing. But with all of this, it's unfortunate with what's going on that dilution has been happening. I understand Mullen's been building a company. It's unfortunate that reverse stock split happened. I understand they want to be NASDAQ compliant. Really what happens over this next 1 to 2 weeks will really tell us what Mullen's big plan is, if they drop any big news, if we stay above a dollar. I think that will be very positive, and this stock should move up because then people will start to believe, okay, they're NASDAQ compliant, they've been dropping good news. Maybe it's time for more institutions to buy into this company. Maybe Mullen is actually doing something big in the EV sector. And that brings me to my next point with RRDS. So Lawrence is dropping like these little teasers, I guess, lately on Facebook. And he said, still humble and shall always remain humble, making America better. And he put the RRDS contract basically that Mullen posted a couple months ago in December, I believe. So why would he do this? Does this mean that RRDS and Mullen is about to drop amazing news with the government? Because also Lawrence has been saying, if you knew what I know as a shareholder, you would not be concerned. So I do believe RRDS will have business with Mullen. I don't think there's a reason that they put out that news a couple months ago for them not to have business. So it's interesting as you start to line all the pieces together, Lawrence is stating that big things are happening, Mullen's the next Tesla. All of the things that he has been saying, very positive. His technology is great. It's already in DC in these vehicles, and he gets paid when his technology is in vehicles. But now he's posting this, which he didn't need to. You know, he wrote two sentences and then posted the RRDS link. So what do you think this means? Does this mean that Mullen and RRDS have a contract and they're about to announce it this week or next week? Because that would be huge. Government contract, any production news, any military contract would be huge. And just so you all are aware of who RRDS, you can read this above me right here. But basically, since 2014, they've been able to execute on 2,500 federal government delivery orders. That's pretty amazing. As you can see, contracts with my fund ceilings of $4 billion in 2021, U.S. Secretary of Labor, Iron Vets Medallion Award during an award ceremony at the U.S. Department of Labor. RRDS is all about providing solutions to the federal government, said Mullen's manager of government sales, Ronald Dixon. Whether it's designing products to meet Department of Defense missions, requirements, or enhancing supply chain logistics, they have a remarkable success record. In addition, RRDS will be a key vehicle supplier to the General Service Administration in an awarded 5-year multi-billion dollar contract. We are focused on selling our EV products to the federal government and view this relationship as a strong step in accomplishing that goal. That's a pretty bold statement. With the federal government's strong interest in electrifying a growing portion of its vehicle fleet, which we've already seen in DC, right? Lawrence was out there, he shared his technology. It's in the Chevys now, okay. $680,000 contract, that was just one. Mullen's commercial portfolio is a very well positioned, said RRDS SVP Federal Fred Bauman. So that's awesome that he also made a statement about Mullen and why they're interested in it. Mullen's Class 1 EV cargo van launches this year and will be the only Class 1 EV van in the market. Remember, Randy Marion guy said the same thing. There's no competition with the Class 1 EV vehicle that Mullen is offering. This is why I stay bullish on them. It is 100% electrified, making it a strong fit for federal government business. Mullen Automotive is proud to team up with the RRDS for U.S. government fleet opportunities for our Class 1 EV cargo van, said Mullen CEO and Chairman David, which we don't care about, right? Because he's putting in all these tricky words into these 8Ks. We don't know if they're going to dilute more or what they're going to do. I'm hoping that they have enough money right now and they don't dilute until later. I understand companies dilute, a lot of companies dilute their stock to raise capital. And I understand that they need money, but I'm hoping for the best right now. We look forward to working closely with RRDS in meeting the demand for EVs across the US government fleets of vehicle. And then here's a little bit of RRDS in 2018. It was the fastest growing defense contractor, top 1.5% of fastest growing companies in America. You could read all of this. This is on their website, but in 2020, obviously more news, but one of the most important things in my opinion is who is RRDS's customers, right? And you can see it right here. Their customers are the Department of Defense, pretty big, US Department of Homeland Security, Department of Justice, and Department of State. So guys, hopefully this video was helpful. Drop a comment on your opinion with the 8K. Let me know what you think about this RRDS partnership. I think it's gonna be huge. Do you think news is gonna come out this week or next week? Why would Lawrence be posting this kind of stuff? Appreciate you for watching. We'll see you on the next one.